Big up, everybody. It's your girl Sophia, aka Sophie, back here on Sophia's Football Talk. As I wasn't able to do a watch along for this very epic game for the last and final group of the FIFA Women's World Cup, which is Group H. You know, your girl had a headache, but I was able to watch both of the games, you know, nail-biting moments. And whatnot. I had definitely a lot of anxiety watching those two games, but I was thinking I need to at least have enough energy to do a little bit of a match reaction, you know, just to talk about an historic moment, especially for the Moroccan women. All right, so before we fully go into all of that, make sure you give this video here a big thumbs up. And of course, also subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We did pass 2K subscribers very recently, and we are on the road to 3K subscribers. So if you want to be a part of the family, subscribe, hit the notification bell button, and also feel free to join the SFT membership. Link is in the description box. But let's dive into nitty gritty. So primarily the game here, you know, that was showcased here in Norway was the South Korea versus Germany game. And I was also trying to on my iPad have on the Morocco versus Colombia game. That was the one that I was mostly excited about. And I was thinking, could Morocco do it? I believe Colombia, they got this, but Morocco, can they? And they did. After having like a horrible opening game against Germany, getting slapped up 6-0, you were thinking, this, you know what? You made history by just qualifying to the Women's World Cup for the first time ever, right? Haven't done that before. Also having your first hijabi player in a FIFA Women's World Cup ever. That's epic. Already made history. Pew, pew, pew. Great. But then in Morocco's second game, they won against South Korea 1-0. Okay. This makes it a bit different, you know, interesting. And then you see Colombia winning against Germany in their second game. Okay. Ooh. And obviously in their opening game, they did win against South Korea. But you're like, okay, this makes it definitely interesting. But obviously, a lot of people were thinking Germany, on paper, they should be slapping this group up. This group should be done. You know, the second place, that should be a bit more open. But initially, number one spot, without a question, without any doubt, should have been Germany. But no, what I really love about Cup games, especially when it comes to the World Cup or even the Euro Cup, anything can happen. Okay, Hollywood couldn't write this. This plot wouldn't be created by Hollywood even. But Morocco did the unthinkable, the unachievable. They did it. They won their final game against Colombia 1-0 with a penalty, 100% deserved, by the way. And then Germany, they needed to win their game, but they drew against South Korea. South Korea, even though, you know, haven't done very well throughout this tournament after their second game, it was already kind of pretty made clear that they're not going to advance. They're out. But, and then you would assume, okay, Germany, they just have to win or potentially get a little bit of help from Colombia, which they didn't get at the end of the day. But it just, even though you're playing against an opponent that is already out, doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to be automatically in, because you also need to put your, what should I say, your effort into it. You know, you can't just be like, okay, I'm going to cruise like nobody's business. No. South Korea put up a honest, great fight. They were defensively sound. The thing that Germany definitely had to their advantage is putting in those crosses, because they have incredible, you know, people that's really good with the head, okay? Especially Alexandra Pope. Her sister should have had 5 goals in that game. Even though it ended 1-1, she should have had lots of goals. She did her end, but they weren't able to do a lot more. I think they maybe woke up a bit too late and whatnot. But I just have to say I'm so proud of both Morocco, but I also want to give a shout out to Colombia, especially one of the big profiles here, Linda Caicedo, who you know, is 18 years old. We heard about the incredible story of her getting ovarian cancer when she was 15 years old, right? 3 years ago. And now she's in the World Cup, okay? And helping her team progress into the round of 16. It's just, it's an incredible story. And with Nohaila Benzina for her team, okay? Showing a lot of other young women out there, yo, if I can do it, you can do it as well. It's incredible. There's so many underdog stories happening right in front of us within this World Cup that's been hosted by Australia and New Zealand. Even though New Zealand, obviously, they got their exit, it's been a lot of eyes looked into this World Cup, and I've been utterly entertained 100%. When it comes to Morocco's story, I ain't gonna lie, it was really beautiful. I had tears in my eyes for sure when seeing how, you know, excited and how much it meant to them to finally qualify. Once again, we need to remember this is their first ever World Cup, and to be able to qualify, okay, advance to the round of 16 was incredible scenes. I do want to see, this is the moment they found out. It's beautiful. Beautiful. The moment they found out that they had advanced, gone through. Looking at the group, as y'all can see, it's quite an open group, 100%. Look at it. Colombia with 6 points. Morocco also with 6 points in second place. And Germany almost missed out, just about, with 4 points. Korea with 1 point. Getting that against Germany, who's won the World Cup twice, okay? Germany, they should be having cover. There needs to be conversation being had with the fact that they got knocked out for the very first time in the group stage. When I say that, it's on the women's side. Also, the men, that they did that. I remember back in against also Korea in South Korea in the Brazil World Cup back in 2014. Okay, that was already pretty shocking then. And I'm pretty sure that the South Korean men didn't also get through themselves. They were already knocked out, but they put up a credible fight by winning that game, actually. And you see it here almost 10 years later, the women doing the same thing. Not winning, but knocking out the women's Germans team. So there needs to be made potentially uncomfortable conversations to be had. But I just think it's going to be incredible to see how far can this Moroccan team go. How far can the Colombian team go as well? Speaking of the Moroccan team, I mean, one of three other teams, for the very first time in the women's team, to actually see three African teams advance to the round of 16. We have South Africa, Nigeria, and then you have, of course, Morocco. Incredible. Me as a fellow African, you know, my family, they're from Somalia. I'm born and raised here in Norway. Norway is still, obviously, they also advanced to the round of 16. That's basically the team that I'm going to be following along with through this tournament. But I still want to see how far can my fellow Africans go. And as well as with Colombia and all, you know, the smaller teams within South America and whatnot. It's awesome. History is being made here, people. So I cannot wait. I will be doing more watch-alongs. Next watch-along will be, of course, Japan versus Norway on Saturday. So make sure that you have on the notification bell button so that you don't miss out. But I want to hear your thoughts. Did you guys catch the games? How do you feel about Germany getting knocked out? Does there need to be conversations being had? What about Morocco being history makers, Colombia, you know, also breaking barriers and whatnot? Let me know all about that, your thoughts, down below in the description box. And I'll see you guys in the next video, which will be very, very soon. Peace out. Have a great day, everybody. See y'all soon. Like the video, by the way. Bye.